Everyone, welcome to your second class of the chapter Motion and Time. I hope you are doing well in this pandemic situation. So last day we have studied what is the motion and what is slow and fast moving objects. And in that class we have discussed about that when a cycle, if you ride any cycle, so cycle moving slow and the bus is moving very fast. So that depends on the speed of that object. So last day we have discussed about the slow and fast. So today we shall discuss what is the reason behind that. So the term is related, that is speed. So our discussion today depends on the speed. So what is a speed? So if you see any car, that car, when the road is clear, car is moving very fast. So that means we can say that the speed of the car is much higher. Now if any cycle is moving in a road, so the motion of the cycle is slow, so we can say that the speed of the cycle is very less. So speed the term, the term speed, it is depends on two things. One is distance and number two is time. How? Suppose you have to go from A point to B point and the distance between them is 100 kilometer into 4 hours. So you can go with a normal speed. If you have to go 100 kilometer within 4 hours, so you can go with a normal speed. Now if you have to go that 200 kilometer, if you have to go 200 kilometer, suppose, in that 4 hour, so your speed must be higher than that speed. So your speed of this distance must be higher than this initial travel. So if we have seen that if the distance increases and if the time is fixed, the speed should be increased. So this speed is related with distance. And the second thing, if suppose we have to go 100 kilometer within 4 hours from A to B, suppose 100 kilometer we have to go within 4 hours, so we can go with normal speed. The speed should be normal. But if same distance, that means 100 kilometer, we have to go within 2 hours, then we have to increase our speed. That means we have to run the car very fast to reach that 100 kilometer within the time. So if we achieve the same distance in a short time, we must increase the speed. So speed is related with distance, speed is related with time. So let us see what is actually speed's definition. So speed, the definition of the speed is the distance traveled. So speed of an object is the distance traveled by it, the distance traveled by it in unit time. So speed of an object is the distance traveled by it in unit time. So the formula we can write, speed is equals to distance traveled divided by time taken. So let's see an example. Suppose you have a car. So you have a car and by this car you have to go to your home. Suppose this is your home, to your school, suppose that the distance between your home and your school is 10 kilometers. So the distance between the school and your home is 10 kilometers. And by car, you reach the school within 2 hours, suppose. 2 hours. So what is the speed of the car? So the speed of the car, if you put the formula, if you put the values in the formula, that is distance travel divided by time taken by the car. So distance travel is 10 kilometer and that is 2 hour. So 5 kilometer per hour is the speed of the car. So 5 is 10, so 5 kilometer per hour is the speed of the car. Now this formula is actually to measure the average speed. Do not think like that the always the speed of the car is 5 kilometer, that means the whole path the speed of the car is 5 kilometer. No, it is not like that. The 5 kilometer per hour says that the average speed of the car is 5 kilometer per hour. Means in some places there will be jam, there will be traffic jam, and for some cases the road is clear. So when there will be jam, the speed becomes slow. When there will be clear road, the speed will increase. So the speed is actually the average speed of the car that is given, that is 5 kilometer per hour. That means for some cases it may happen the speed falls 2 kilometer per hour. Suppose there is a traffic jam, so the speed becomes 2 kilometer per hour, and here the speed, suppose the road is clear, so here the speed becomes 7 kilometer per hour. But if you calculate the average speed, that means total average speed, so that will be the total distance but total time taken, that is 5 kilometer per hour. So that is called speed. So the formula of speed is distance traveled divided by time taken. So speed becomes distance travel by time taken. So sometimes we are writing that is speed equals to distance by time for our. So sometimes we can write that is speed equals to distance per unit time. Now from this equation we can also calculate what will be the distance. So distance will become speed into time, isn't it? Distance, the formula of distance will become speed into time. Now what will be the time equation? From same equation we can write that time will be distance by speed, distance divided by speed. So from one equation we can make three equation. So that each equation, first equation gave us the formula to calculate the speed, the second equation give us the formula to calculate the distance, and the third equation will give us the formula to calculate the time. So that is the equation. Now we want to find what is the unit of speed. Unit of speed. So to calculate the unit of speed, here you can see the unit of speed. Sorry. Okay. The unit of speed. What is the formula of speed? Distance per time. So we can write unit of speed will become unit of distance divided by unit of time. So there will be many units of speed. So the small unit, smallest unit, or the very useful unit is, suppose unit of distance, there will be unit of distance, there will be meter, there will be centimeter, there will be kilometer, there will be millimeter. So many units of distance is present. Similarly, time units is also, there will be many units like second, like minute, okay, like hour. So we can use any of the units of this in this place. So if you take meter and second for distance and time, so the unit of speed will become meter per second. So we can write meter per second. If you take centimeter and second, it will become centimeter per second. If you take kilometer per second, it will become kilometer per second. Okay, if you take kilometer and hour, if you take kilometer and hour, so the unit of speed become kilometer per hour, unit hour. or it can be write kmph, that means kilometer per hour, kmph. Also you can take kilometer per second, also you can take millimeter per second, also you can take meter per minute, anything you can take. So the largest unit of the of speed is kilometer per second. That is the largest unit. Means it is very large, not largest, it is very large unit of speed. But we are using for our laboratory experiments to calculate the speed, we are using the unit meter per second. This is very useful unit. And to calculate the speed of any car or any bike or any anything, we are using kilometer per hour or kmph, kilometer per hour. So if you see any cricket match, you will be you can see that after delivering the ball, in the screen just below of the screen, the speed of the ball is mentioned. So here you can see, suppose the speed of the ball is 140 kilometer per hour, it can be, it will be like that. In the screen you can see where the score is mentioned. After that, after delivering the ball, you can see the score, the speed of the ball is mentioned for each and every particular ball. So that unit of the speed is kmph, that means kilometer per hour, or sometimes it is miles per hour also. So that is the speed. I hope you understand what is the speed and what are the units of speed. Now we are going to discuss about odometer and speedometer. So this is an instrument by which we can measure the speed of any vehicles. So often you have seen this type of instruments in the bike or if in the car also. So actually this instrument is showing the driver or the rider what is the instantaneous speed of that car, means what is the speed of that car in that moment. So if suppose this is the dial, so if the dial is in this position, so if I take any other color, okay, if the dial is in this position, so it will be, it is mentioning that the speed of the car at that instant is 40 kilometer per hour, because this, the unit is mentioned kmph, that means 40 kilometer per hour is the speed of the car. If the dial is in this position, so it is mentioning that the speed of the car is 80 kilometer per hour. So that is called speedometer, by which we can calculate what is the speed. So an instrument on a vehicle's dashboard which indicates the speed, which indicates the speed, is called speedometer. And another thing is odometer. What is the odometer? Odometer always give us what is the distance traveled by the vehicles. So here you can see 1 meter is present. Let me choose one light color. Okay, so here you can see a meter is present, in which if you go more and more, the meter will go, a meter will rise its number. That means this meter always shows what is the distance traveled by the driver or by the vehicle. That is the odometer. So odometer always tell about the distance traveled by the car. Here you can see also odometers are present. So these are the odometers and these are speedometers. So I hope you understand what is the speedometer, what is the odometer, and what is the utility of that, and also what is the speed of an object and what are the units of that. So that's it for today only, and in the next class we are going to discuss about some numerical of speed, and we are also calculate how to calculate the speed, how to calculate the distance, and some important numerical we shall discuss in the later class, in the later on. So stay safe, stay home. Thank you everyone for watching this video.